task facing him, and what a day for these two teams. Spurs seem to have overcome their colds and flu. John Duncan, Cyril Knowles fit. Martin Chivers back as sub. A strange-looking Chelsea side. No John Hollins. Peter Housman out. Steve Kembry is sub. Really is a day when the club have got one eye on the present and one on the future. We've seen skipper Ray Wilkins now joined in the side by 17-year-old John Sparrow, who of course has played before, but making his first league appearance for the club, 18-year-old Londoner Teddy Maybank. The referee today is Jack Taylor of Wolverhampton. The crowd is the biggest of the day, 51,000, with the gates closed and thousands locked out.
So away we go, except that there's a false start. So away we go, and it's Chelsea attacking the goal to our right in an all-blue strip against Spurs in the white shirts, and Cook was right in there straight away. Both sides staring the second division in the face, and a win here today would at least ease the problems for either side. Tremendous tension here. Young Butch Wilkins, Ray Wilkins there, the new Chelsea skipper. Knowles now for Tottenham, who've been plagued by colds and flu this week, and Cyril Knowles was one of them. In the air, Duncan trying to nod it there for Jones. Wilkins in there setting a good example for Chelsea, the young skipper. Finding Gary Locke. Maybank nodding it down, and Wilkins available again. Played off beautifully by Wilkins for Britain now. Can Chelsea... Oh, what a save by Jennings! Oh, brilliant save by Jennings! A superb ball by Butch Wilkins, and Britain timed his run beautifully, and what an excellent piece of goalkeeping again by Pat Jennings. Show themselves in this game. Now it's with Conn. Perryman couldn't get in there and really had no chance, but Jones could. But now Cook can take it up for Chelsea. Wilkins, Maybank really playing a lone hand up front now, but here's David Hay joining him. This looks better for Chelsea as Maybank tries to get in there with a header. It comes now for Charlie Cook, chipped in delicately again. Oh, and what a save again by Pat Jennings from Hutchinson. Well, they are two tremendous saves that Jennings has made. What a lovely bit of football though by Charlie Cook, delicately floating that ball in there, and Hutchinson gave it all he could, and even then Jennings was equal to it. And back inside the penalty area now. Knowles with the free kick for Tottenham, floated to the far side. Oh, and Phillips was under pressure there, vitally pushing it over. Knowles, if anything, floating there just a little too close to him, and Phillips able to turn it over. A corner then to Tottenham. Duncan in the six-yard area. Perryman again there, and again Sparrow gets it away as far as Naylor. A little dink forward, and Hutchinson is right back there using his height to good advantage for Chelsea. Now it's with Alfie Conn. Nice little touch there. Osgood turning it in first time, and again Mickey Droy is there for Chelsea. Perryman trying to turn it there towards Neighbour, and Kinnear is right in there too, shadowed by Harris, in another corner for Tottenham. So Harris will take the free kick for Chelsea. Curling again towards Droy. Beal, oh, now Charlie Cook! Yes! No! Handball! Handball! Cook says it hit him on the shoulder. Well, as that came down, Charlie Cook says the referee, so the referee says, control that with his arm, whacked it into the back of the net, all for nothing. Jones. Good play by him. Oh, and what a good save by Phillips. Superb little skill by the young Channel Islander, Chris Jones. He turned Harris inside out, hit a superb left foot shot all in one movement, and over the crossbar. Phillips fisting that one away, but only as far as Alfie Conn. Now Conn getting in behind that defence again, but also putting his cross behind the goal. First half, Spurs now attacking the goal to our right, knowing that a victory for Tottenham would take them out of the bottom three. Naylor, Duncan right in there, and Wilkins getting it away. Naylor again for Tottenham, played nicely there, and Duncan with a shot. Oh, and Phillips just got down there to turn that round. Difficult to say from this angle whether it was on target or not, and not hit all that cleanly. But Phillips had to get down quickly to push that away from John Duncan. Towards Duncan. Now for Joe Kinnear. Again, Troy almost on his knees to get that one away to Charlie Cook. So away goes Cook. Maybank away on the right. Britton coming up in support. Now with Maybank. Britton. Back for Locke. Time to measure up that situation and look for Ian Hutchinson. And now Perryman can bring it away for Tottenham. Hay is after him, but that's a good ball by Perryman. Nicely into the path there of John Duncan, who's got Jones in the middle, but problems with Sparrow. Still got it across, though. Now can Jones turn? He's played for Perryman! Yes, and Tottenham have scored! So Perryman has done it. And so much credit down that right touchline to Duncan. And when the ball finally came over, Jones couldn't find the angle, but he had the sense to find Perryman. And for Perryman, in the end, it was a simple job. Spurs 1, Chelsea 0. Tottenham's free kick, aimed towards Chris Jones, the backward header, it might go in, no! Well, Jones had a quiet enough start, but he's improved with every minute in this game. Having Gary Locke to take the free kick. They've planted everybody now, bar the kicker, bar John Sparrow, and bar goalkeeper John Phillips forward now, Chelsea. Spurs are outnumbered in that defence, but Osgood got the header in. There's Harris with the kick, and he miskicked badly. Kinnear only putting it right back into trouble. Dry up there with the header. Wilkins now trying to chip it back in again. Jennings there with his fist. Troy there with a shot, and he's over the line. No, there was a handball by Troy. It's been disallowed. Disallowed. That's the second time Chelsea have had the ball in the Tottenham net today, and the second time that it's been out for handball. That time, according to the referee, Mickey Droy handled the ball. Goal disallowed. Despair on the bench. Droy up there with a header. Butch Wilkins. Play for David Hay. Tremendous competitive game now with so much hanging on it. Now for Maybank. Trying to burst his way through, and my goodness, on a ricochet went no more than a yard wide. Chelsea throwing everything at Tottenham now, just as Tottenham had thrown everything at them in the opening minutes of this half. Brian Mears in the centre there in the light raincoat, with Ron Stewart on the left, his general manager. They've really got problems ahead now if Chelsea lose this one. Hutchinson there, bravely looking for the ball again. Cook with that delicate little chip in there that might cause problems. Oh, and he's lost it! Wilkins! Oh, and he's pretty wide! What a miss! And his teammates coming across to say, look, don't let it worry you. But once Jennings had lost that ball, Spurs were in trouble. And when Wilkins picked it up, it looked as though they were lost. And then the ball went wide. Spurs will take advantage of that. Jones. Dry there for Chelsea, and Duncan is after him too. It'll come to Jones again. That's a good-looking cross as well, and it's not out of play, and Hay had to put it there. Corner to Tottenham. Jimmy Neighbour with the corner then for Tottenham. Perryman was right in there. It'll come now maybe for Alfie Kahn. Yes, by Kahn! What a superb goal by Alfie Kahn. The darling of the crowd, and even more so now. As the ball came over, it came out to the edge of the area where Kahn was poised. Pass Phillips, 2-0. Spurs 2, Chelsea 0. Harris planting it forward towards Hutchinson. Oh, and there's Britton in there in a good position. Now, can Chelsea fight right back? No, they can't. And a goal then would have meant so much to them. Terrific goal, though, by Alfie Kahn. Could well just about have sewn it up for Chelsea. Took so long to settle in at Tottenham, Alfie Kahn. It could well be that that vital second goal is one that helps keep Spurs in the first division. Who knows? Wilkins. Bullock. Wilkins again. Chelsea going gamely forward still. Britton now on the edge of that area. Can they yet turn up something? Maybank is there. Made wide again for his skipper, Butch Wilkins. And there's the cross going in towards Pat Jennings. Oh! That was a tremendous frontal assault there by Hutchinson on Jennings. He lost the ball just for a fraction of a second. Made sure he grabbed it in the nick of time. Hayes header. Here's Perryman. And the final whistle goes to the roars of relief from all the Tottenham fans. Spurs two such valuable points. Alfie Kahn with a brilliant second goal to add to the one scored also in the second half by his skipper Steve Perryman. Spurs 2, Chelsea 0. It gives Spurs a glimmer of hope. It puts Chelsea deeper in trouble towards the bottom end of the first division. A final scoreline then here at White Hart Lane. Spurs 2, Chelsea 0.